You're watching NFL Daily. I am Tom Downey here with an NFL draft only mailbag for you guys on Chat Sports. And as a reminder, if you want to be on these mailbags, you need to be subscribed or at least follow me on Twitter. First up from Gamer Dude, which team will Aidan Hutchinson go? (2) Hutchinson, I think, is pretty much a lock to be a top five pick, depending on how the order shakes out in terms of the teams and needs. There is a very real chance he is the number one overall pick in this year's NFL draft. He was incredibly productive this year for Michigan, able to convert speed to power exactly how you're searching for. If he goes number one, I think whatever team drafts him should feel pretty good about that selection. We'll stick with Michigan here from James Yoder. Tom, longtime fan, first-time reply guy. Is it possible that both Aidan Hutchinson and David Ajabo both go top 10? First off, James, you'll have to watch my mock draft coming out later today. I think it is possible. Now, Hutchinson is for sure going to go top 10. I think Ajabo, if he turns pro, and I think he should, ends up being a first-round pick. Teams are always coveting edge rushers. Ajabo's year opposite Hutchinson was fantastic. We've seen some good Michigan edges in recent years. Winovich, Josh Uche. These two, I think, are better than both of those guys. Maybe they both only go in round one, but if the need arises and teams do need pass rush help, I think Ajabo could go in the top 10. Now, if you guys want more NFL draft mailbags, type in me in the comments section. That way I can show the bosses, look at all these me's. Just scroll through the comments. You'll see hundreds of them. That way I can keep doing NFL draft videos for you guys. So help me out by helping yourself out and typing in me in the comments. One question from my Twitter, from Rico Lynn. Which teams would use their first-round pick on a quarterback despite this year not having a definitive number one QB? Fantastic question. Now, the Lions with two first-round picks, I think, are a contender. Houston, maybe at 3. I think that'd be a bit of a reach. Maybe top of round 2 could make some more sense. Or I can see how Davis Mills plays the rest of the year. I don't think the Giants would, but they should consider it. Or maybe they trade down, get future draft capital for next year. The Panthers, I think, should consider it. If the Falcons didn't do it last year, I don't think they would do it this year. I think Philadelphia kind of falls in the Giants category, not yet. I think mid part of round 1, there are going to be some real contenders. Maybe Minnesota, probably not. The Saints, the Raiders could make some sense. Pittsburgh, Denver, Washington, Detroit is another late round pick. I think once you get into that area, that mid part of round 1, you might see a little run on QBs. So how many quarterbacks go in round 1? And there will be some quarterback trades this offseason, I promise you. Get your predictions in for me at the pinned comment. You should know the deal by now. The ad break comes on YouTube. Head down there and make your predictions. From Alex Green, should Denver draft a QB in the first round or wait and see who falls to them in the second? I know you meant who, not why. If I'm Denver, I think I'd actually trade for a quarterback. I think the rest of your roster is in really good shape. You've got a pretty good veteran head coach in Vic Fangio if he sticks around. Good receiving core, tight ends, ground game, O-line's pretty solid. I would trade that first-round pick for Russell Wilson, Aaron Rodgers, hell, maybe even Matt Ryan. That's the route I would go if I were Denver. I'd push all my chips in right now and try and win with a veteran quarterback. We had two questions on this prospect, and I was quite surprised to see that one go down. Tyler, it's pronounced Beatty. Big mistake. He's got to go by Batty. What a missed opportunity, my friend. Carter, and I forget who else made this comment too. I think you guys have a draft sleeper here in this particular name because Tyler Beatty was not that impactful in previous years at Missouri. This year, though, he very much broke out. He had a massive season and emerged as a very productive football player. Now, I think the consensus, top backs are Kenneth Walker out of Michigan State, Breece Hall, Isaiah Spiller. I think you can maybe throw in Zach Charbonnet in that category, a Kyron Williams there as well. I'm a big Zonovan Knight fan myself. I think James Cook, Dalvin's, I'm pretty sure that's his brother or it's his cousin. Brother confirmed? That's what I thought. At Georgia, those are names that I think are maybe above Beatty right now, but I think that's a good sleeper name to keep an eye out for. He can come back if he wants because COVID rules, but you're back. You should almost always go pro. And if you guys want a fantastic deal, how about some NFL hoodies for 50% off at chatsports.com/NFL hoodie. I'll put that link in both the comment section and in the description. Save you guys a little bit of time and money in the process. Up to 50% off, a perfect gift this holiday season. So if you forgot to buy something for Christmas, that's okay. Go do it right now for yourself or for a loved one. NFL hoodies for your favorite team at chatsports.com/NFL hoodie. From Eric, could Treylon Burks be the first wide receiver off the board? I think he could be. I don't think he ends up being. I am a big Burks fan. He has been kind of the big slot guy in the past 2 years for Arkansas, but he's shown some outside ability as well. Fantastic production. He makes KJ Jefferson look better than he is. But it's another strong receiver class. Garrett Wilson, Jameson Williams, Drake London, Chris Olave, Burks, I think Jahan Dotson too, are all potential first-round picks. And frankly, I think they'll all end up being top 32 guys on my board. So I think Burks goes in round one. I don't know if he is wide receiver one, though. From Jacoby, does Cleveland go after a receiver or quarterback in the first? I don't think you can go after a quarterback in the first round if you're the Browns. And I know you might be out on Baker Mayfield or worried about Baker Mayfield or whatever. I don't think there is a better prospect right now than even current Baker Mayfield. Now, Kenny Pickett, Carson Strong, Matt Corral, of course, they could be better than Baker, but that's a pretty big gamble for a team that, even with some quarterback issues this year, is still firmly in the playoff mix. I would much rather go draft a receiver, and that's exactly what I would do if I were the Browns. My guess, it's very early right now, it's December after all, the top receiver on the board for the Browns when they're on the clock, that is who their pick should end up being. Now, if you want more free videos on the NFL draft, college football, NBA, general NFL, free agency, head coach candidates, all that stuff, hit that big red button and subscribe today. That way you don't miss out on anything right here at Chat Sports. From Caden Smith, is 7 too high for the Jets to take Tyler Linderbaum and some overall good player fits for the Jets? I think corner in particular, you got to get some help there. I think Derek Stingley is a good fit for the Jets with their first pick in the first round. In terms of Linderbaum, I know there is some concern about his strength. I love the kid. I think he is a stud. I know he's under 300 pounds. He can bulk up, and he was awesome at Iowa. Now, he's not quite Quentin Nelson, guard to center, like in terms of like the level of prospect relative to their own position. Nelson is the best player I've ever scouted. Linderbaum is not quite that level, but I think he's damn good. So if you want to pass on and move on from Connor McGovern, I got no problems if that's the route you want to go inside the top 10. Linderbaum is up there for me with my favorite NFL draft prospect this year. So too is Kyle Hamilton, I think also a good fit for a team like the Jets. But what do you guys think? Who is your favorite NFL draft prospect? Get those votes in for me in the comments section. From Winterskull69, nice. The Dolphins pick an O-line or running back with their first-round pick. I know that the Dolphins have been missing a big-time back for years now. They've had chances to take one, didn't do it. I still think you got to go offensive line. This Dolphins O-line, part of a musical chairs situation, has not done very well. Austin Jackson, I think he's a bust. Liam Eikenberg, Jesse Davis, haven't played that great. You got to find more offensive lineups, whether it is at guard or at center or whatever, or tackle even. I would take lineman over a back. Take a back in round two. You'll get a very similar prospect at a much cheaper opportunity cost. From a fat guy, given the growth of DJ Reed, Trey Brown, and Sidney Jones, should Seattle draft a corner? Now, DJ Reed's a free agent, and that is a potential issue for Seattle. Trey Brown got hurt again. Sidney Jones has fared better. Seattle very light on draft capital. I would still look at the cornerback market if I were Seattle, but because all three of those guys have played better, especially if you bring back DJ Reed, I think the Seahawks would be a little bit okay. As you can tell, some of these questions came in from my Twitter, and if you want more NFL draft coverage on social media, hit me up on my Twitter. If you have questions, just DM me. My DMs are open at What going down to that link, by the way, will be in the comment section and the description for you guys as well. From Alex, probably shouldn't say the back half there. How many linebackers will go in the first round because Parsons, producer Marshall, love that name. This is a great question. This is a very philosophical question, too. Micah Parsons, the off-ball linebacker, has had plenty of value this year. He's been a little bit better than hoped in coverage and been solid in run support. But the value for Parsons, what has made him a defensive player of the year candidate, is the pass rush ability. And it, to an extent, is what has made Parsons so unique among linebackers. He's not just doing edge rushing. He's not just playing the linebacker role. He's been even more unique than Devin White was for Tampa. So I don't think there is a next Micah Parsons in this year's draft class, a guy who can do off-ball and edge so seamlessly. Now, in terms of the top off-ball linebackers from that category, Devin Lloyd out of Utah and also N'Kobe Dean out of Georgia, both fit that, can play all three downs, all three roles, blitzing, pass rush, etc. They can handle that pretty well from that perspective. So I would keep an eye out for those two guys going pretty early. But I don't think it's because of Micah Parsons. I think if you're chasing that, you're going to end up being a bit disappointed if you're an NFL team.